Hola Lucía, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo estás?
Muy bien, gracias a usted.
Sí, todo bien, gracias, me alegro.
Yo también.
Ok, what time is it? ¿Qué hora es?
Es la 1:30, es la 1:15, es la 1 en punto.
Alright, so that was a brief review about how to tell time. Okay, so when we are telling time, we are going to use es en son. Okay, es la 1:30. Son las 2:15. O, por ejemplo, 10 menos cuarto. So that is 9:45. So 10 menos cuarto. Okay. Okay, let's also have a brief review on interrogative pronouns or interrogativos. Okay, what,
¿Qué?
why,
¿Por qué?
when,
¿Cuándo?
how,
¿Cómo?
which,
¿Cuál?
in plural form.
¿Cuáles?
Alright, muy bien. Who,
¿Quién?
and the plural form.
¿Quiénes?
Alright, so let's try to use some of these interrogative pronouns, okay? So, what's your name? ¿Cómo te llamas?
Me llamo Lucy.
Where do you live? ¿Dónde vives?
Yo vivo en España.
Muy bien. Why are you here? ¿Por qué estás aquí?
Porque está mi familia.
What's your favorite food? ¿Cuál es tu comida favorita?
Mi comida favorita es pescado.
Alright, so in Spanish, what verb are we going to use to show our likes and dislikes?
Gustar.
Okay, so the verb class is gustar. So let's try to conjugate the verb gustar. First person singular.
Gusto.
First person plural.
Gustamos.
Muy bien. Second person singular.
¿Gustas?
Second person plural.
¿Gustáis?
Muy bien. Third person plural.
¿Gustan?
Muy bien. So we have gusto, gustamos, gustas, gustáis, gusta, gustan. All right. Expressing our likes and dislikes, aside from conjugating the verb gustar, we also use indirect object pronouns. So just like what we learned, the indirect object pronouns are we have me, nos, te, os, ¿qué más? Le, and les. So we are going to use indirect object pronouns to express our likes and dislike using the verb gustar. Okay, are you ready?
Sí, profe.
Muy bien. Okay, first person singular.
Me gusta.
Second person plural.
Nos gusta.
Muy bien. Second person singular.
Te gusta.
Second person plural.
Os gusta.
Third person singular
Le gusta.
and third person plural.
Les gusta.
Muy bien, so we have me gusta, nos gusta, te gusta, os gusta, le gusta, les gusta. Alright, so let's try to have some examples using this verb gustar with the indirect object pronouns. Okay.
Me gusta escuchar música. ¿Te gusta escuchar música?
Sí, me gusta escuchar música.
¿Os gusta comer pescados? ¿Les gusta ir a centro comercial?
Me gustan los fines de semana. Me gusta el día viernes. Okay, can you see the difference there? Me gustan y me gusta. Why are we going to use me gustan? Why? Because our verb or our subject is plural in form. Me gustan los fines de semana. Okay. Me gusta el día viernes. We are going to use me gusta only because our subject, el día viernes, is singular in form. Okay. So you take note of that. All right, class. So for our main topic today, we are going to continue discussing pronouns, particularly on numbers or numerals. So you know that there are four kinds of numeral pronouns in Spanish. So let's find this out in our lesson for today. Are you ready?
Sí, profe.
Okay, so let's go.
Thank you.
Alright, so we're back. So for today, we are going to continue discussing pronouns. So we are going to focus on Spanish numeral pronouns. So just like what we learned previously, pronouns are words that take the place of nouns. Alright, so we are going to discuss the first type of Spanish numeral pronouns. So the first one is cardinal. Okay, so when we say cardinal number, so it states the exact number of a certain object being talked about in the sentence, for instance. So can you give me examples of cardinal numbers or yes, cardinal pronouns in Spanish?
Pues empezamos 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 32, 40, 51, 100.
Alright, so that is the normal counting, okay, that we use. So that is cardinal number, okay? So it gives the exact number being asked, for instance, okay? So if I say, ¿cuántas personas hay en la fiesta?
Hay 30.
Muy bien. ¿Cuántos invitados hay en la celebración?
25.
Hay 25. Okay, so 25 es un cardinal, okay? Es un pronombre cardinal, okay? So those numbers, those cardinal numbers are examples of pronouns, okay? So we are going to continue with another type of a pronoun, and that is ordinal. Alright, so when we are going to use ordinals, they refer or they express the position or rank of a certain object. Okay, so I'm going to say those ordinals in English, and our bright student will say them in them in Spanish. Okay, so example, we have first,
primero,
and of course we also have here, when we state ordinals, there are masculine and feminine. Okay, so let's continue. First,
primero, primera.
Muy bien. Okay, second.
Segundo, segunda.
Third.
Tercero, tercera.
Fourth.
Cuarto, cuarta.
Okay, so cuarta. Cuarta en Filipinas means money, dinero. Okay, fifth.
Quinto, quinta.
Alright, sixth.
Sexto, sexta.
Seventh.
Séptimo, séptima.
Eighth.
Octavo, octava.
Ninth.
Noveno, novena.
And 10.
Décimo, décima.
Okay, so we end up to 10 because these are the common ordinals that we use to describe or to modify or to express the position or the rank of a certain object. Okay, so let's try to have some examples, okay, using these ordinals. Are you ready?
Sí, profe.
Muy bien. What was your rank in the singing contest?
Fui la primera.
So you were the first. So la primera is an example of an ordinal. So it states the rank of Lucía in the singing contest. Okay? Ella fue la primera. Alright. How did you get to the finish line? ¿Cómo llegaste a la meta?
Fui la segunda.
Okay, so she was the second. Okay, so second or la segunda in Spanish, okay, is another example of an ordinal. Okay, so she made use of segunda and primera because she is female. Okay, so we have to use the female gender. Alright, so if the speaker, for instance, is masculine, then of course you are going to use primero o segundo. Okay, fui el primero.
Fui la primera.
Okay. Fui el segundo.
Fui la segunda.
Okay, so you see the difference. Okay, so you have to take note who the speaker is, if it is masculine or feminine. Okay? Alright, so are you ready for the next type of pronoun?
Sí.
Okay, so let's go. Alright, so let's proceed with the third type of Spanish numeral pronoun, and that is fraction. Okay, so can you give me examples of fraction? Okay.
Tercio, medio, la mitad, o mitad.
Okay. Let's try to have examples of fractions in Spanish, okay? So, for instance, 1/4. How do you say that in Spanish?
Cuarto.
Cuarto. What about 1/2?
La mitad.
What about 1/3?
Tercio.
Okay, muy bien. So, those are the common Spanish numeral pronouns that we use to represent fractions. All right. Okay, so those are very easy, right? So these three words, when you go to the market, for instance, you're going to buy a kilo or 1/2 of pork, for instance. So, you know, you have to master...
Un cuarto.
Yeah.
La mitad. La mitad. Medio kilo.
Un tercio. Un tercio. 1/3. All right, so those are very basic, okay, that we have to know when we are going to express, okay, the fractional part of a certain object. So let's proceed with the fourth type of Spanish numeral pronoun, and that is multiplicative or multiplo or multiplicativo in Spanish. Let's say, for instance, if you are going to double a certain object, so how are you going to say it?
Doble.
You are going to triple it, so that's times three or three times of the same object.
Triple.
Okay, what about four times?
Cuádruple.
Five times.
Quíntuple.
Six times a certain object, the same object.
Sextuple.
Seven times.
Septuple.
What about eight times of a certain object?
Octuple.
What about nine times?
Nonuple.
And let's say 10 times of the same object.
Decuple.
Alright, so normally we use only the first two, doble, triple, or?
Cuádruple.
Cuádruple. Okay, so the other multiplicatives are not common. Alright, so if you are going to express how many times a certain object, so you are going to use multiplicatives. Alright, so let's try to have some exercises using this Spanish numeral pronoun. Alright, so we are going to use these numbers as pronouns. Okay, how many English books do you have? ¿Cuántos libros de inglés tienes?
Tengo 10.
Alright, so 10 signifies a Spanish numeral pronoun. How many paintings do you have at home? ¿Cuántos cuadros hay en tu casa?
Hay 3.
Muy bien, so 3. 3 or 3 is an example of a cardinal pronoun. Alright, next examples. How many euros do you have left in your purse? ¿Cuántos euros te quedan en la cartera?
Me quedan 80.
Alright, so 80 is a number pronoun. Okay, next. How many people attended the party? ¿Cuántas personas acudieron a la fiesta?
25.
Alright, so 25 is another example of pronoun. How much assignment did you do? ¿Cuánta tarea hiciste?
Hice la mitad.
How many kilos of pork did you buy? ¿Cuántos kilos de cerdo compraste?
Compré 1/4.
How much money do you need for the field trip? ¿Cuánto dinero necesitas para la excursión?
Doble.
¿Necesitas el doble?
Sí.
Alright, so that ends our lesson on Spanish numeral pronouns. So these are very simple, okay? So it's very easy to memorize these numbers, okay? So whenever you are talking to Spanish people, then it would be easy for you to speak these pronouns. So this is very basic lesson, okay? But this is very important whenever we are talking with the people we meet every day. So that ends for today.
Thank you for watching.
Okay, so hasta luego.
Adiós.
Chao, chao.